worksheet. Already we have finished one of the worksheet. Today we'll go with the one more worksheet. Which of these methods are used to separate a solid from a liquid? How to separate solid from a liquid?
By evaporation.
Only evaporation. See, they have given different options there. Sedimentation, decantation, filtration. Decantation, filtration, evaporation. Next, decantation, winnowing, threshing. Sedimentation, dissolving, condensation. How can you separate solids from a liquids?
Solid
from a liquid. How do you separate rice and water?
By filtration.
Before filtration, they both are mixed.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So rice will be some time it takes to settle down. The process is called as what? Settlement of any particles.
Sedimentation.
Then we need to separate water, right? Water, no? The process is called as
decantation.
It goes sedimentation, it goes decantation, then again filtration. Yes or no? So we have three processes: sedimentation, decantation, as well as
filtration.
Next, this process is used where the components of a mixture are of different sizes. Which process is used to separate mixture of different sizes? For example, stones, pebbles from sand. See, do you know sand?
Yes ma'am.
All the sand particles are same?
No ma'am.
The some more big, some will be high.
Yes ma'am.
How to separate it? Small amount of glass pieces which are bigger in size are mixed with the sugar.
We can hand.
What will remove?
Glass.
As they are big, safely have to remove the glass pieces. Instead of that, what you can use? Separate sugar? Metal sieve you can choose. Metal sieve, do you know? Some holes will be big. Whatever the sieve we use, now here we use only for the floor.
Yes ma'am.
Metal sieves will be somewhat, will be having big holes.
Okay.
Next. A separating process that is a combination of evaporation and condensation.
Evaporation?
There is a process called, some name it is having, where it goes evaporation as well as condensation. What is evaporation? Next, strawberry sugar syrup used in ice cream is an example of
ma'am. Repeat.
Strawberry syrup. In ice cream, we will be using some syrup to color
yes,
flavors.
Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah. Is it saturated or unsaturated? What is saturated?
Which
can take more soluble to dissolve in it. Unsaturated, which could not take more soluble. Where you can sit down small sugar crystals.
Yes, ma'am.
It is called as unsaturated. Where you can see plain water, it is called as
saturated.
So here the strawberry syrup is saturated. That
saturated.
Means more
saturated.
Sugar, it is
yes,
not in each.
Yes, ma'am.
Next. So here is the one more process. Study the following flow chart and find out X, Y, and Z. What is X, what is Y, and Z? So here is the mixture. X plus Y plus Z. When it is filtrated, filtration is done for it, then it gives a substance called solid. That is Z. That means it is solid. So X, Y, Z, these substances are mixed. When this mixture is filtrated, what will get a solid Z. Okay, next, after that, it gives solution X plus Y. Again, here X is also solid. So two solids, one liquid. So how to separate that?
By.
See the outlines here. Sawdust, sugar, water. Sawdust and sugar both are solid, but water is the
liquid.
So what is the answer? Chalk powder, water, sawdust, salt, water, sugar. By filtration, can you separate salt and sugar?
No.
So this is not the answer. So that means by doing filtration, we have separated one solid.
Yeah.
That means there are two solids which will dissolve in the water and which will not be dissolving in the water.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
If you consider salt, water, sugar, then salt will be dissolving, sugar will be dissolving. Is that correct option?
No, ma'am.
Next, chalk powder, water, sawdust. Chalk powder, will it dissolve in water?
Yes.
It will not dissolve. Sawdust, small dust particles. They will also not dissolve. So this is also not the option. Next. Sugar, water, sawdust.
Sugar, water, sawdust.
Will sugar dissolve?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
sawdust?
No, ma'am.
That means this case, Z is sugar only by doing this Z is sawdust. If this mixture is filtrated, all the dust we can see on the filter paper.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
So Z is what? Sawdust. And what we get solution X plus Y. That means sugar plus
Y.
So X is solid, no? So X is sugar.
Sugar.
So we'll get sugar. Water, salt. Clear?
Yes.
Next. The sequence of separating for mixture of salt, sand, camphor. Salt. What is salt, sand and camphor? How do we do it? What process should be taking?
Salt.
Yes. Sand.
Sand.
Camphor. Already we had it salt and sand.
Salt.
Did we do?
Yes.
What we have separated? We have mixed in the water.
Then we have to evaporate.
First,
evaporate.
At last, it is salt. Okay, during filtration, you will get salt. But they gave you a camphor. Now, how to do? How to obtain camphor again?
Camphor by this.
What process?
Sublimation.
Sublimation.
If you need camphor, what happens? The camphor flakes will be coming from the dish, no, on the china dish. If you close the lid, what happens? All the camphor forms into vapor and touches the top of the lid.
Yes.
Okay. Due to the temperature above the lid, it becomes cool and forms into camphor again. There camphor is collected. Again, what you have? Salt.
Salt and sand.
How to separate it? We know that. By adding water, heating.
Yes.
So first is sublimation, afterwards we have to add water, then we have to filter sand, we will get
next
then
after
the evaporation. Okay. When a bottle of soda water is opened, carbon dioxide escapes producing a fizz. This is due to when you expel soda bottle or any,
yes,
you will get some fizz sound, no?
Yes.
Yes. What is happening there? Carbon dioxide is evaporating. It comes out of carbon dioxide.
Yes, ma'am.
So what is happening there? The decrease in solubility. Solubility will be decreasing. That means it will not dissolve the carbon dioxide. And pressure increases. Due to pressure, sometimes cracks even comes up also.
Yes.
So pressure and temperature increases. Next. In the process of separating, it is used to separate heavier particles and a mixture from lighter particles. How to separate heavier particles and lighter particles?
By
sieving.
Winnowing. Heavier particles husk, it is lighter particle, and waves are heavy particles, no?
Yes, ma'am.
So how to separate heavier particles and lighter particles?
Winnowing.
By throwing it up, lighter particles fall due to wind away. Heavier particles fall down. The process is called as what?
Winnowing.
Which of these methods could be used to separate the insoluble solid from a soluble solid? Insoluble means the solid which will not dissolve in the water. For example, just now we have the sawdust.
Yes.
Will not dissolve. Whereas sugar and salt will dissolve.
Yes.
Okay. Now let us see. Mixing the mixture with water and then filtering it. Can we obtain this? By mixing this water with the water and afterwards filtering. Then we could evaporate the sand from the resulting solid. Can we?
No.
No, ma'am.
We cannot do filtration first. We have to do first water.
Yes, ma'am.
Then filtration. Then we get what?
Then we get
sand and sand. Afterwards we have to do
evaporation
first. Mixing the mixture with water and then filtering it. Mixing it with water, then filtering it. Then we could evaporate the water. Yes?
Yes, yes.
So this is the correct option. Next. Choose correct alternative to complete the given analogy. Butter from milk, churning. Do you know butter from it is made? This is
yes,
called churning. Okay, this is the correct sequence. Then salt from seawater. What is this process called?
Salt
from seawater. What is the process called? How do we get salt from the seawater? Which process is used?
Evaporation.
Then why your face is vegetable face is doubtful? Now, see, he has taken. Oh, student name Mohan has taken 4 containers. In that, he took lemon juice, vinegar, ink, and groundnut oil. Okay. Then he added some water.
In all,
he added some water. So which will be soluble or which will be mixable? Which not be mixable?
Oil will be mixable.
Groundnut oil will not be mixable, but remaining ink, vinegar, and one
more
is
lemon juice.
Lemon juice will be mixable. Next one. On a sunny day, a student have performed an experiment that he took 100 ml of alcohol and water in separate vessels. Alcohol he took in the glass and then he took water in 2 separate glasses. He kept in a sunny day. Okay, later on after some time if you go and observe, he has seen that almost more amount of alcohol has been evaporated. More amount, that means alcohol percentage, alcohol is less, water is more. He took same amount of water and alcohol, but in the evening if he go and see, he saw that only less amount of alcohol is there and little bit more amount of alcohol is there. So what is the statement we can give here?
Alcohol evaporates very fast.
Alcohol evaporates faster than the water. Okay. Next. Now, Path is preparing lemonade. Lemon juice he is preparing. So you want to add salt, sugar, and ice in lemon juice. Okay, lemon juice you have. You want to add salt, sugar as well as ice. Which sequence he has to add?
First,
salt
or
sugar.
Second,
also
salt or sugar.
Next,
ice.
Why ice at the last?
Because
why? Because if the temperature is more, any solids will be dissolving faster. If the temperature is less, that is, it is cool, it takes some more time.
Yes.
Clear? So here there are some process. Tea leaves from tea. How we separate it? What is the process to separate it?
Sieving.
That mixture.
Yes, ma'am.
Filtration.
Butter from mutton milk. Butter from milk.
Churning.
Butter from milk.
Churning.
No, what is
it?
Yes,
ma'am.
Sand from water.
Sand from water.
Sand or decantation water will be having some impurities, no? Yes. I am asking some water, not impure water. Okay, so to obtain pure water, we will take the filtration again. We will keep it filter paper. Paneer from milk.
Churning.
We will use lemon juice there.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Afterwards, what we will do?
We will boil.
After boiling, we will be filtering. Yes. All the hard substance will be on the mesh and liquid will be falling down. Next. So this is a one diagram here. So this is a jar. This is some solution. Okay. Where here you have some sugar crystals. And this is the water. Which solution is it? Saturated or unsaturated or super saturated?
Saturated.
Yes. Why it is saturated?
Because the sugar.
Sugar crystals are not dissolving in it. That means how much it is there, it has to remaining is are let down.
Yes.
So it is saturated solution. If it is mixed completely, then because it is unsaturated. Next. Suresh, you want to separate mixture of sand and water? Okay.
It is evaporation.
Filtration.
Wait. You want to separate sand and water? Okay. So he took a flask like this. And in the beaker, he is having sand water. Okay. He kept a funnel. It is falling. Directly, he is pouring the water. Will you get pure water?
No.
What the step he has missed there?
Filter paper he did not keep. Yes, ma'am.
If you keep filter paper in the funnel, then the water will be purified. Okay. Next. One more. They have to take beaker. Okay. Then they have kept a funnel. Okay. Then they have to take one more beaker where all the solids are down and liquid is here. Water is falling into the funnel. Only water is falling here. Okay. And here you have a filter paper and there are some dark particles here. What are these particles and what is this one?
That is a water.
Insoluble means residue, we call it as. Okay. These both are residues. Okay. Because after filtration, we have got this process. We have got these things.
Yes.
They are called as residues, and these water is called as what?
Filtrate.
Because they did not say it is exactly water. They said some substance. Okay. So this whatever for the process for the liquid here filtration is done, that liquid is called as filtrate. And what are the impurities have come? It is called as residue.
Clear? Ma'am, what is it, ma'am?
Residue and filtrate.
Okay, ma'am.
Clear, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
So,
ma'am,
what everyone understood?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is regarding the worksheet. Okay, any doubts?
No, ma'am.
You'll be having IIT exam prepared well. Okay. Soon.